Audible signals having frequency range from 20 Hz to 20 kHz. Now, to transmit the electromagnetic wave of frequency 20 Hz, suppose. Now, frequency is equal to 20 Hz and the speed of electromagnetic wave is 3 into 10 4 8 meter per second. And we calculate its wavelength. Wavelength lambda is equal to C by nu. C is 3 into 10 4 8 by 20. It is equals to 1.5 into 10 power 7. It is approximately equal to 15 into 10 power 6 meters or 15,000 kilometers. 15,000 kilometers. Lambda by 4 approximately equal to 4,000 kilometers. Means the minimum height of the transmitting antenna we require here 4,000 kilometers to transmit the signals of 20 Hz electromagnetic waves. To transmit the electromagnetic waves of frequency 20 Hz, we require at least the height of the transmitting antenna or receiving antenna is 4,000 kilometers, practically which is impossible to construct the antenna of size of height 4,000 kilometers. So if we increase the frequency, by increasing the frequency, the wavelength will be reduced. If wavelength is reduced, then size of the antenna will be reduced. How we can increase the frequency? We are not increasing the frequency of original message signals. The original message signals are mixed up with the high frequency signals. When they are mixed up, the resultant frequency will be more. When frequency increased, automatically wavelength decreases, size of the antenna also decreases. Even though, let's try to find to transmit the signals of 20 kHz, how much wavelength is there and what is the minimum size of the antenna we find now here. Lambda is equals to C by nu. Here nu is 20 kHz. 20 kHz is 20 in 10 power 3. Now it is 1.5 in 10 power 4 or 15 into 10 power 3 meters, means 15,000 15 kilometers it is. 15 kilometers. Lambda by 4 approximately 4 kilometers. Even though the 4 kilometer height also practically not possible to construct. So that is the reason why we should do the modulation of the signals. Modulation means we are mixing the low frequency signals with the high frequency signals so that the frequency will be increased. If the frequency increased, wavelength is reduced. If wavelength is reduced, the height of the transmitting and receiving antenna also reduced. That is the reason why to reduce the size of antenna, we should do the modulation. And let us try to understand to increase the strength of the signal and to transmit over long distances, we should do the modulation. By doing modulation, the frequency of the signals will be increased. When frequency increased, here strength of the signals also increased, energy is increased. If the strength is increased, automatically they can propagate over through long distances. That is the reason why to propagate over long distances, we should increase the strength of the signal, means we should do the modulation. Thereafter, to avoid the mixing of signals with the another message signals already present in the atmosphere. For example, I am talking here and my voice has to reach some other person. Whenever these signals are propagating from me to that person, now these signals may be mixed up with the some other low frequency signals already present in the atmosphere, then that person cannot receive the desired signal. That is the reason why to avoid the mixing up of message signals with the another low frequency signals already present in the atmosphere, we should do the modulation. By doing modulation, the frequency of the message signals is increased so that with these signals, another low frequency signals cannot be added. So we cannot get the disturbance, means the noise cannot be added to the desired signals.